Hey everybody, what's going on? There's plenty to get into in today's video surrounding the Montreal Canadiens, but before we do that, let's talk about the sponsor for today's video, which is the BetStamp Sports app. If you're looking to line shop, this is the place to do it, and line shopping is so important in terms of the sports betting space right now. There's so many sports books, and you're going to want to find the best possible price for the game you're looking to bet on. For example, tonight's Boston Bruins versus New Jersey Devils game. You can find on the Coolbet Sports app the Bruins as minus 123 favorites, but there's better odds out there on the North Star Sportsbook. You can find the Bruins at minus 110, and if you're going to want to be able to get into the sports betting space, you're going to want to use these type of lines to be able to get the biggest advantage possible, and of course, you're going to want to use the minus 110 odds for the Bruins, so line shopping is important in doing that. Now, there's a lot to dive into with the Montreal Canadiens before they head into their mini holiday break here. They'll take on the Dallas Stars later tonight in Dallas, and there's just a lot going on surrounding this hockey team at the moment, and I think it's time that since we're around the Christmas break right now to kind of discuss what we've seen from Martin St. Louis in the first portion of the Montreal Canadiens schedule this season as a first-time head coach. We know we saw what he did last year when he came in relief of Dominique Ducharme, but it's time to start evaluating him because there's growing a sample size here, and you're starting to see more and more trends develop from what the Montreal Canadiens can do under their new head coach. I think we're pretty much at the point now where the honeymoon phase is over for St. Louis as the Habs head coach. There was a lot of momentum driving the decision-making behind making him the new head coach last season, and initially that certainly paid off for the Habs, and you're starting to see the growth of some of the younger players on the roster, which is exactly what you were hoping for when he was brought along as the new head coach. Player development was obviously going to be an integral part of what they were trying to do, considering they were in last place in the NHL standings last year, and there's been some pros and cons in that aspect of St. Louis as the head coach for the team right now, and I think there's some interesting things to notice in terms of the younger players on this team and where they're headed in the future. If you look specifically at Juraj Slafkovský, there's some interesting things that you're noticing of late. If you look at his ice time, it doesn't really get cut throughout the first two periods of a game right now. You're starting to see St. Louis take a little bit of an easier route with him during the third period, especially when the team is down or in need of a goal, which is kind of interesting to me because of how he's looked, especially over the last 2 or 3 week stretch. I think he's playing some of the better hockey that you've seen, but of late, he's kind of struggled a little bit more after that benching that he received a couple weeks ago. So I think there's some interesting things that are noteworthy with this. I wonder if it has to do with the overall cardio aspect of Slafkovský's game. I know there's some people mentioning that online, and it did get me thinking about that as well. So I think that's noteworthy to bring to the conversation here. Slafkovský is definitely a player that needs to continue getting more ice time, but he's also a big player and he's getting adjusting to the speed of the North American style game. So I think we need to give St. Louis the benefit of the doubt here in terms of knowing what he's doing with this young player, because he knows the overall importance of what Slafkovský means to the future of the team. So I think he deserves the benefit of the doubt for the time being, especially when you consider how he's handled some of the other Montreal Canadiens young forwards, whether that's Nick Suzuki or Cole Caulfield. You're seeing them have much more offensive freedom in his type of system. And I know it's not really a system. He likes to play in concepts, and I think that's a very smart way to play hockey in 2022. So I do believe that's what St. Louis is trying to preach here for this Habs team moving forward is going to pay dividends for what the team is hoping to accomplish within the next 5 seasons. Whether St. Louis is the head coach, when they do get to the point of being a contender, I don't really know the answer to that question right now. They might need a coach who has a little bit more structure, but that's a question for a different time and something we'll talk about later. But for now, St. Louis, I believe, is doing a solid job, especially if you look towards the back end and what some of these younger defensemen are doing. I know he doesn't deserve all of the credit for that, and some of that can go towards the defensive coaching that the team has done as a whole. But if you look at Caden Gooley, he just continues to get better and better. You're starting to see much more offensive skill in his game, which is something that some people thought was lacking, and that's why they only pictured him as a number four or number three defenseman in the NHL. But I think he's showing this year as a young player that he has that offensive potential to be a top pairing defenseman in the NHL, and honestly, you can color me surprised with that kind of a a statement at this point in time, because I didn't really believe he had that ceiling as a top pairing defenseman when he joined the National Hockey League, but he's proven me wrong so far, and I think there's only room to grow for him. So I think that's another area that St. Louis has done well with on the back end. He's allowing these players to make mistakes and continue to grow, whether it's Arbor Jacki, Jordan Harris, or Caden Gooley. The youngsters are being put in a position to find success, and I think that really just goes down to what St. Louis is preaching as the head coach of the Canadiens. That's it for me today from Cook's Corner. As always, let me know in the comment section down below what you think of the job that Martin St-Louis has done as the Montreal Canadiens head coach to this point. Of course, there's still a lot of room to grow for him as a head coach, as well as what he brings to the table as a head coach too. So just let me know in the comments what you think of his job so far. I'm Zach Cook. We'll see you later.